going on? This is Marthy Styles back with another YouTube video. How have y'all been? Me? I've been feeling like telling y'all how to be a better commentator. Because I think a lot of people are really close to being great commentators, and they just one little thing, couple things they might be missing. Now, I'm not the greatest commentator in the world, but I think I know a couple of things, you feel me? Now, one tip I can give you is really watch a lot of other commentators. People who we all know are great commentators, watch them. See what they do well. You know who is really good? Who he don't do the commentating as much as he used to, but he's a good example of what I consider to be a beast commentator, and that's DeMarcus J. He came out with a lot of punchlines. He was like freestyling on a microphone, man. He was just letting it fly, man. And the inflection in his voice is what draw you in. A lot of people don't understand when you talk on a microphone, you have to have inflection in your voice, because when you sound like this, this is incredibly boring. And yeah, and I just want to try, if you talk like that, that is not entertaining. This is actually quite boring. And if you talk like this through the whole video, most people will click off the video. They won't want to listen to everything you have to say because this is incredibly boring. Even if a lot of amazing things are happening in the background, this is incredibly boring. You see what I'm saying? That's not entertaining. You'll be like, oh my man, this is boring. And if you don't have Beast gameplay on top of that voice, that man, checkmate, you over with. You can't, people don't want to listen or hear that. You know what I mean? And I'm not saying you got to be all loud and crazy like me. You don't have to be loud or crazy. You can freak it like this. Hey, we got this game in the background and I hope y'all enjoy it. And right now, I'm sitting here drinking on a cup of tea. You know, I mean, you don't have to be super flamboyant with it. You just gotta have ups and downs in your voice. You know what I mean? You can't just be monotone. You can't be like a laser beam with it. Like, laser beam, like, so when you talk like this, everybody, this is all they hear. Nah, you gotta be like, I know I sound goofy, but you know what I'm saying. So, you know, you sitting there, yo, I was sitting up in the crib, and then this guy came in, you know what I mean? You pretty much need to just have a lot of action in your voice. And there is a way to get away with that. And I'm gonna bring up Drifter because he gets away with that because he is very informative. He has tons and tons of information he's throwing at you. So a lot of people come to him because he is like super smart and has a lot of information. So he can get away with that type of thing. But people who are not bringing vast amounts of knowledge cannot get away with having a monotone style commentating. What? Man, you know what I'm trying to say. And another tip is don't limit yourself about what you talk about. I know there's some people who only talk about the gameplay, and there's some people who only talk about topics, you know, that has nothing to do with the gameplay. And in the beginning, I put myself in that little box of only talking about topics because I came in the middle of Ghost, and by the time I came, everything already been done and said, so it was no point. But I kind of regret that because now a new game's coming out, so there's a lot more to talk about, and I find it easier to talk about the gameplay right now because it's still fresh and new. So what I would say is mix it up. Some days talk about topics or something that you know you care about, and some other days talk about the gameplay and just have a nice little blend and mixture. And it keeps it fresh because people don't know what you're gonna bring out every video. And that's another thing. Try to make every video completely different from your last video, which is kind of hard if you're talking about the gameplay every video or you're talking about just topics. Because if they know that you're known for that, they're gonna expect, okay, he's just gonna talk about another gameplay, or he's just gonna talk about something he's seen. You know, just mix it up. And I'm fully aware that some games and some communities specialize in certain things, like the GTA, they specialize in glitches and funny moments and stuff like that, so they can kind of get away with it because there's a lot going on in that game. But kind of like Call of Duty channels, it's a little different because it's not as much going on in the game where you can constantly just keep talking about the game. I don't know, that's my personal opinion. Oh, look at that, the beat changed. That's another thing you can do, just unexpected moments like the beat changing in the middle of a commentary. I guess this is not the middle. I'm talking for a long time, ain't I? And that's another tip. Sometimes just random things that you might just pop in a video is funny and entertaining to people. So you could be talking about something that just blurt out, I like watermelon or something like that. I don't know. And I really don't like watermelons, so don't go there. And see, here's another tip. You can change your tone in the middle of a video. You don't always have to be the same emotion through the whole video. And you probably seen that for me. Like, I'll go from loud and wild to calm and cool like this. And to me, it just keeps people engaged and interested in what you're saying, even if you ain't saying nothing. Like right now, I ain't really saying nothing. I'm kind of blabbering on. The video just going on and on and on to the break of dawn. That's a little rat, old school. But I think unpredictability is also a nice tip, because when people just don't expect what's coming and they're like, oh wow, didn't see that coming. You know, I really think that keeps the video entertaining, you know. So these were my tips and contradictory tricks about how to be a better commentator. This is the second part of this series where I'm just rambling and on about how to be better on a microphone. I will come out with part two of how to be a better rapper pretty soon. I just gotta get my notes together, and I think I'm gonna go hard on how to rap fast, because a lot of people have trouble doing that. This is the end of the video. Tell me what you thought. Peace out and much love. I really like this. It's real nice and peaceful. Follow me on Twitter. Damn, Malty, this video is long.